Good evening. First tonight, a 37-year-old father has died after a mining accident in Ballarat, which also left a colleague fighting for life. The Australian Workers' Union claims a manual method of drilling under unsupported ground triggered the rockfall, 500 metres below the surface of the Ballarat gold mine. It's now pushing for the operator to face industrial manslaughter charges.
Kurt Hourigan went to work at the Ballarat gold mine and never made it out. Shortly before 5pm yesterday, a rockfall occurred where the 37-year-old was working.
It's devastating because, yet we've lost another worker, and no worker should be injured or die at work.
29 miners ran into a safety pod, but Kurt and a young colleague were trapped. Specialist crews rescued the 21-year-old 3.5 hours later and airlifted him to hospital, but they couldn't reach Kurt safely.
The scene was needed to be made safe before that they were able to access that patient.
They reached Kurt early this morning and pronounced him dead. The miners had been working 500 metres underground and about 3 kilometres from the entrance to the Ballarat gold mine.
This should have been avoided. They should not have been doing that task in that mine.
The union claims they had been doing a form of drilling called airlegging.
Airlegging means that the people who are doing the excavation are near the rock face. They're actually close to where the excavation's taking place.
And the union claims that task was being carried out on unsupported ground.
This was a quick, cheap and easy way to chase gold.
But as a rule, we don't work under unsupported ground. It's a no-no.
The mine is in lockdown and WorkSafe has taken over the investigation, but the AWU is pushing for the operator, Victory Minerals, to be prosecuted under Victoria's industrial manslaughter laws.
Our members have raised concerns about this style of mining, and it seems to have fallen on deaf ears. There's no point creating laws to protect workers if we don't use those laws.
Victory Minerals refused to speak to media today but released a statement saying it's cooperating with WorkSafe and undertaking its own investigation. The company insists safety is its first priority.
All mining does inherently carry a risk, and it's the mine operator's duty to ensure that those risks are managed appropriately.
The mine produces 40,000 ounces of gold annually.
And for thousands of years, people have lost their lives in pursuit of gold, and just continues, and here it is happening again.
This time it has claimed the life of a young father and left another man fighting for life. Samantha Butler for 10 News First.
And Samantha Butler joins us live now. Sammy, what will WorkSafe be examining during the investigation?
Well, Jen, WorkSafe will be examining a number of factors as part of this investigation to get to the bottom of how this tragedy unfolded, as well as a thorough examination of the scene. They'll be looking into whether safety concerns were raised about airlegging at the mine, whether it's a safe practice to be doing at this site and how long it's been happening, as well as whether it was indeed being carried out under unsupported ground. WorkSafe says it will be a complex and detailed investigation, and it's likely to be a lengthy one. They do have a window of up to 2 years to decide whether or not to pursue any form of criminal prosecution. At the same time, a separate investigation will be conducted by Victoria Police on behalf of the coroner to understand how this mine collapse could have claimed the life of a 37-year-old father. Jen, it is a terrible tragedy for Ballarat, a city which has already endured so much, from the devastating bushfires to the disappearance of mother of three, Samantha Murphy.
Okay, thank you very much, Sam. And Jack Perry joins us live now from the Alfred Hospital. Jack, what's the latest on the injured miner's condition?
Good evening, Jen. A 21-year-old male is fighting for his life here at the Alfred after he was airlifted following yesterday's mine collapse. Now, it's believed he suffered serious injuries to his lower body after being pinned down by rocks. Now, the CFA had a special team called Oscar One, along with expert paramedics, which took them 3.5 hours to get down to the mine. Now, the tricky thing is it was 500 metres deep, but he was 3 kilometres along the mine, which means he had to get saved by these people, assess his condition, get out of the mine and airlift him back to here the Alfred, where he's now fighting for his life. Jen?
Okay, thank you, Jack.